I think we can really say that the European Parliament profoundly influenced the revision of this Olaf regulation. You have supported all the Commission proposals to strengthen the effectiveness of investigations, as well as our objective to base the relationship between Olaf and the EPPO on the strongest complementarity. In addition, you have pushed to ensure that Olaf's stronger investigative tools coexist with stronger procedural guarantees. In fact, the revised legislation established a controller handling complaints by persons concerned, allows the person under investigation to access the final report under certain conditions, and provides for the respect of higher procedural safeguards when Olaf supports the EPPO. These amendments should increase the protection of persons subject to investigation and also increase the reliability of Olaf's work, even though the rules on admissibility of Olaf collected evidence in subsequent criminal procedures will go unchanged. Honourable members, we should soon start implementing a new financial framework accompanied by an ambitious recovery plan. It's crucial that the Union will be ready to protect the European Union citizens' money, ensuring that money is spent properly and effectively. And having said this, also in response to Mr. Freud and others, I think we have now provided the necessary financial means to the different organizations. And in particular, if I constantly hear EPPO should get more money, I think they have, even before they start working, the same staff number than EPPO, than Olaf. And it's not about, because you have to include the decentralized prosecutors, and then you certainly arrive at the same number. And may I say, the original concept of the EPPO was to focus very much on the work of the decentralized prosecutors. But now we see a very strong headquarter. But again, I think we should see how it works, how it comes into operational daily work. And then, of course, we have to adapt to the needs and see what are the future needs. And I was very clear in the discussions. There are opportunities like amendment budgets, etc., where we can, so to say, react in case there are further needs. But first, I think it's now we should really pay attention that EPPO can start as soon as possible, hopefully in spring, finally its work, and then I think we can have a further assessment about the future needs. Be reassured that we have every interest to protect not only our money, but also to get it back in case there are frauds, there are criminal cases. So I think indeed, I think it was said by Mrs. Shea and others, it's something which should really pay off in the way that we get the money back, and both institutions, but also others dealing with such issues are indeed properly equipped because they need it. And finally, they will certainly take care that at the end of the day, we get the money back and certainly more than we have to invest into the staffing and the financing of these institutions. But on the other hand, we have to see that everything is in balance and we really lead also by example. And finally, we are talking today primarily about Olaf, and that's why I would again like to highlight that the revised Olaf regulation is a key element of the new EU anti-fraud architecture that we are building to achieve that objective. And this is not only about the cooperation between Olaf and EPPO, because here, of course, it's about the investigative and prosecutorial powers of EPPO, which are now there. But we should not forget there's also Europol, and its analytical capacity has to be used. And the same applies for Eurojust, which has definitely a coordinating role. So the reformed Olaf is a centerpiece, if you like, of this architecture to carry out even more effective investigations. What we have to achieve is a proper coordination, cooperation amongst all these institutions. It's not only about the two, but again, that's why I have mentioned this. We should not forget Europol and Eurojust and the cooperation with these organizations, and to have complementarity and avoid overlapping. So also this would contribute to more effectiveness of European institutions and instruments. Thank you very much.
Kiitos, komissaari Hahn. Ja nyt tämä tärkeä keskustelu on päättynyt, ja voin ilmoittaa, että Marinescun mietinnön osalta käsiteltäväksi ei ole jätetty ehdotuksia neuvoston kannan hylkäämiseksi, eikä yhtään tarkistusta työjärjestyksen 67 ja 68 artiklan nojalla, joten voin ilmoittaa, että säädösesitys katsotaan näin ollen hyväksytyksi, ja suuret onnittelut esittelijä Marinesculle ja kaikille teille kollegoille, jotka ovat saaneet tämän työn nyt päätökseen, ja kiitokset komissiolle ja neuvostolle myös. Ja voimme nyt sitten siirtyä seuraavaan asiaan.